it so happens that my coming to America, particularly when looked at from much later times like now, seemed to coincide with the political situation in Germany. However, as I've often emphasized, I got my offer in October 1930, and I came in January 1931, at a time when the Weimar Republic was still in power in Germany, and my coming had absolutely nothing to do with Hitler or the Nazis, nor do I have any Jewish ancestors. Quite a few people think, well, he came to America, he's probably part Jewish. Well, it so happens I'm not. Not that I'm particularly proud of that, but it simply is a fact. Well, when I got finally this very good offer from the American Museum to become curator of the Whitney-Rothschild collection, naturally I accepted it. But my wife was German too, and we felt at that time we still had a lot of the German ideas and ideals and culture and so forth. And we, as we had a saying, that one doesn't change citizenship as one changes a shirt. And I was particularly, in a way, annoyed by all my British friends in the United States, none of whom ever bothered to become an American citizen. They said, oh, British citizenship is good enough. I'll stay British. And I said, well, German citizenship is good enough too. Why should I change? Well, I did take out the first papers, and I said, well, if necessary, in due time, I'll probably feel American enough, and I'll take out the second papers. Then when the situation became politically more difficult, Hitler marching into Poland or whatever it was, I applied for citizenship. I said, well, now's the time to become a citizen. Well, while it was being processed, America declared war on Germany, and all naturalization proceedings were immediately stopped. So I was an enemy alien, legally, in America. And nothing particular happened for a long time, but one day, about half a year later in the summer, a group of FBI agents came into our house and searched our house for, I guess, subversive literature or God knows what. And, oh, we had, as enemy aliens, we had to give away my bird gun. I had to give to the police and shortwave radio and so forth. But anyhow, the FBI came, and of course they found, I never read Hitler's Mein Kampf, which they expected that every German would have had read. And however, they, according to an order by the Attorney General or whatnot, as enemy aliens, we had to be fingerprinted, we had to be photographed on first and from the side, and we were formally, I think, arrested and then released again. And if we hadn't had our two American-born daughters who were American citizens that way, I think we probably would have been among the many Germans that were at that time sent to concentration camps. However, we had a lot of trouble all through the war. My wife was not permitted to leave the little town of Tenafly without a permission from the Attorney General in Trenton, New Jersey.